A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 19th December, on the front page you have Tribunal reinstates Mistry as Tata Sons executive chairman. So this was what happened 3 years ago actually. Cyrus Palonji Mistry, he was unceremoniously removed from the post of executive chairman of Tata Sons. So now National Company Law Appellate Tribunal has ruled that the decision was illegal and he should be reinstated. So this is the complete detail of the issue too. So he had differences with Ratan Tata and this is what had happened. He was removed. And here you have no stay on Citizenship Act implementation, says Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court has refused to stay the implementation of the Citizenship Amendment Act, which fast-tracks citizenship by naturalization process for illegal migrants from six religious communities other than Muslims, who have fled persecution from Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan. So the CJI orally suggested that the government should publicize the actual content of the act so that there is no confusion among public about its objectives and aims. And this is council votes for 28% GST on all lotteries. So GST council had its meeting. So GST council comprises of the union finance minister and representation from all states, like finance minister of a state or, you know, any other minister member from the state. So GST council has decisions taken on goods and services tax. So here the decision was taken to have 28% GST on all lotteries. So you can see a first time vote on a proposal to tax all lotteries at uniform rate of 28%. Was taken. And so earlier till then, till now, GST Council took all its decisions by consensus. Consensus means all members agree. So since GST has been implemented, but now for the first time voting took place on this proposal. Then below you have four held guilty in 2008 Jaipur serial blast case. So this was a serial blast which took place 11 years ago in 2008 in Jaipur, and this resulted in 71 people being killed and around 200 injured. So five people were accused in this case. One of the accused was charged with sending an email which claimed responsibility for the blast on behalf of Indian Mujahideen. So that person has been acquitted. Other four have been convicted. The quantum of sentence would be announced later now. On page 4 you have NGT refuses to extend deadline for STPs for lakes. So National Green Tribunal has set up a deadline for sewage treatment plants STPs till September 2020 for Belandar, Warthur and Agara lakes as such. So these are the lakes in Bengaluru. So if the work remains incomplete even till September 30, that is next year 2020, a compensation at the rate of 10 lakh per sewage plant per month will be liable to be paid. So this will be recovered from the erring officers apart from adverse entries in their service record and other adverse actions. So this is what the NGT order says, and it refuses to extend the deadline beyond October 2020. And this again, NGT, National Green Tribunal, says complete projects to curb Ganga pollution. So it has set the deadline of June 30, 2020 and warns of compensation in case of failure. So this is a similar move taken here to combat pollution of River Ganga. On page 8 here you have Goa relieved after MOEF's decision on Mahadai project. So Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change has announced that its earlier letter in October 2018 as such will be kept in abeyance. So this letter was the one in which Ministry of Environment had written on the project on Mahadai River. So actually you should know Mahadai River is also known as Mandovi River in Goa, is the lifeline of Goa. And the project which was planned was by Karnataka government to divert water from Mahadai River to Malprabha River. So this is called Kalsa Banduri project of Karnataka. So Ministry of Environment earlier in its letter in October had stated that Karnataka for this project does not need environment clearance. So Goa had objected to it, and now you can see it was October 2019, this year itself. So now the Ministry of Environment says this letter is kept in abeyance. So the nod which has been given is now withdrawn. On the editorial page, the first editorial is quick, not hasty. So this is regarding, you know, conviction of former BJP legislator Kuldeep Singh Sengar. He has been held guilty of raping a minor girl from Unnao, who we have seen earlier how she was set ablaze and she has died of her burn injuries. Now she was fighting her battle. So this editorial says that the conviction is quick. Real deterrence is when there is certainty of punishment without justice denying delays. And this is a duty to publish. So this is regarding RTI. So limiting RTI responses based on locus standi of the applicants could create a chilling effect. So this is what Supreme Court bench, three judge bench led by Chief Justice of India had stated in the RTI case. There are delay in appointment of RTI authorities like the Central Information Commission and State Information Commissions. So on this, the CJI also stated that there is a huge burden on the authorities, and the RTIs which come need to be vetted, that whether they have any locus standi or not. So applicants will be vetted. So it had said that it creates a feeling of fear in the working functioning of the government. But then the advocate in defense had stated to the court that it would create fear and chilling effect only on those public officials who are corrupt. So this is an editorial on this issue, that how what Supreme Court is stating is, if implemented, could have a chilling effect, that whether a person should file an RTI or not, that would also be scrutinized. So that's the point. And this is the last bastions of secular India. So this is regarding universities, Jamia Millia and Aligarh Muslim University. The assault here on students show a dangerous convergence of Modi regime's anti-Muslim, anti-university agenda. And this is Trump cards in the impeachment deck. So this is regarding how US President Donald Trump is, Trump's impeachment is being sought. So the process to pin him down, this article says, could be politically wasteful for the Democratic Party. So Democratic Party is trying to do this. Trump belongs to Republican Party. Then on the op-ed page, you have, are fears over CAA misplaced? That is Citizenship Amendment Act. So this article says, to reassure Indian Muslims, the PM needs to state that the government will not conduct an exercise like NRC. So the fear is on steps which will be taken beyond this, because after CAA, what the government intends to bring out is National Register of Citizens, NRC exercise. And this is regarding calling the US's bluff in 1971. So this says, bold power play by India and Russia held off Pakistan's benefactors in those crucial days of December 1971. The US could not come to its help. Pakistan's help. And this is the rhetoric and reality of capital punishment, that is death sentence. Capital punishment means death sentence. So this says it provides neither justice nor deterrence. So death sentence will not provide justice and it will not provide a deterrence too, is what this article argues. So this is an important issue about capital punishment. On page 12 you have, Center cautious on framing CAA rules, that is Citizenship Amendment Act rules. Intelligence Bureau is monitoring and compiling details of all agitations. And below you have, Bangladesh gives river panel meet a miss. So Bangladesh did not send its delegation to the Joint River Commission meeting with India that was scheduled to be held in New Delhi. So this has cast a shadow over the agreement to share waters of Feni River. So this was taken up during the October 2019 visit of Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina. But now Bangladesh has not come for the meet. Then on international page you have, House set to vote to impeach Trump. So this is regarding the House of Representatives, the lower house of US Congress, US Parliament, which is going to vote on impeachment of President Trump. President says he did nothing wrong and denounces the probe as an attempted coup. So here you can see the House of Representatives has Democrats in majority, Republican of Party of Trump is not in majority. While in Senate, it is the Republicans which are in majority and Democrats don't have enough majority. But this is ruling out independents. There are this is including two independents. Then on business page, you have continuation of the front page news regarding reinstatement of Cyrus Mistry as Tata Sons chairman. But it is said Tata's may move Supreme Court because this is the order given by National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, which was on appeal from National Company Law Tribunal. So from NCLT, appeal goes to NCLAT. From NCLAT, the appeal may go to Supreme Court. So Tata's may move Supreme Court against this NCLAT order. And here you have FADA moves Supreme Court on sale registry of BS4 vehicles. So this is Bharat Stage 4 vehicles. You know, so the Supreme Court has been approached because sale and registry of unsold BS4 vehicles beyond April 1, 2020 will not be allowed. So on this, the Federation of Automobile Dealers Association has approached the Supreme Court. So this is there because we are jumping to BS6 from BS4 now. So BS6 fuel availability will be from 1st April 2020 and most manufacturers would shift to 100% BS6 vehicle production as such. So this will happen from Feb 2020 and March 2020. But what about unsold vehicles? So that is the concern here. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.